Thank you. Bye. Let's go.
Did you find anything good?
Just some matches and some shampoo.
Yeah, I found some bandages and pain relief. Oh man, we're losing daylight. Mm-hmm. We need to find a place to make camp.
Yeah. Let's go in here. Sure?
Yeah, we don't need a house.
Looks like it's in a storm, man.
It's fine. Let's go.
Alright, trust you.
Come on.
Told you we should have stayed inside.
Yeah. It's just a little storm.
So, what's our plans?
We keep on moving.
You got a problem with that?
I'm sorry. It's just, how long can we keep on running until what we're running from catches up with us?
As long as we can.
We need to set up a base of operations. We need to think of a way to be prepared and...
You know what happened last time.
I know, but we can be more careful this time.
How?
We be more prepared. We get more people, get more supplies, we get more defenses,
no.
Get more...
I told Mom that I would take care of you. And that's what I'm trying to do. We survive by staying on the move. If we stay somewhere, we get comfortable. If we get comfortable, we let our guard down. If we let our guard down, well, you know what happened.
It's just, this isn't living.
No. It's surviving. And this is our life.
Well, what do we have here?
Who are you?
Name's Sean. And I put that down if I were you. Now. Good.
What do you want?
Conversation. I didn't catch your boys' names. Your names?
Name's Norman. This is Steven.
Nice to meet you. What brings you boys all the way out here?
Just camping out for the night. Trying to avoid attention.
That's where you fucked up. Here I am. What kind of shit you got?
Excuse me?
Your shit. What you got?
Like, just what you see here.
Wow. That's depressing. Now.
Hey, take it easy.
Where's the rest of your group?
We don't have anyone else, it's just us.
Bullshit. Tell me what I want to know, or I'll blow his fucking brains out.
Norman?
Please, don't.
Then tell me what I want to know.
Look, just take what you want. We don't know anything, it's just us.
Yeah, I don't care all that much. You can give me what I want, or the boy dies.
Please, please just let us go.
Okay, you just don't get it, do you? Nowadays, it's kill or be killed. Gotta be ready for anything. I haven't heard of any survivors in these parts in a while. No one outside of my group. I'm gonna ask you this time. Where's the rest of your people? Oh, fuck it.
Let them go.
You see? I knew there was more of you.
We've never even seen this guy before.
Is that true, friend?
I'm giving you one chance. Let them go.
Who do you think you are? I'm the one with the gun.
You think your gun's gonna keep me from killing you?
Oh. I like you. Now, I've got a question for the lot of you. How many of you are there?
More than you can handle.
Do you have any fucking idea who you're talking to?
No. Either way, it don't matter much to me.
Listen, Fred. I got a group. How about we go back, take what we can from those two idiots? I'll take you to them. What do you say?
Your group. Robbing people, threatening kids. Is that what you do?
We do what we have to survive.
Me too.
Ugh.
Think he's gonna come back?
I don't.
Are you okay?
Thank you.
What you want? You want hunger?
Take them, it's yours. Hey, wait! Don't you want to join our group?
Let him go.
It'd be safer together. Come on. Please.
Okay.
Yeah. He's not though. He's not. He's gonna need some ibuprofen. Holy cow.
Thanks, kid. All the yelling would just bring more of them. Pack up. Let's move out.
Let's do it.
Okay, let's go.
You guys wanna go for that van? clear now. I'll keep watch though.
Yeah. Here, take these. Get up there.
What's your story?
My name's Norman, and that's my brother Steven.
Hey.
Bigby.
Say what?
Name's Bigby Gravesley.
Bigby. It's nice to meet you.
Likewise.
Where are you from? You from around here?
I don't know where here is.
South Dakota.
South Dakota? Jesus.
Yeah, our thoughts exactly. We're from Indiana. We were making our way to the heart of the Midwest. Figured less of a population, so it'd be safer.
Yeah, that's smart. I'm from Colorado.
Is that where you were when it all started?
Yeah. Yeah, I was in Denver.
Oh, man. I can't imagine what it must have been like to be in a city when all this started. How bad was it?
Bad. Everything hit at once. No one was prepared. Those things, they tore through everything. Everyone.
Were you with anyone?
No, it was just me.
I see. We were in a small town. It was just us and our mother. She was already too old for anything like this. She wouldn't have lasted a day. So, she told us to leave her. Told me to look after Steven, to protect him. So we did. And I have been, ever since this all started. Let's fire it up, see if it works. It's dead. Deader than the doornail.
Yeah, we've been keeping a calendar. Today's about 184, so about
6 months. I know.
Yeah. What were you doing before all this happened, or before all this started?
I was a bail enforcement agent.
Oh, okay. What's that?
Bounty hunter.
Oh, okay, so kind of like Mando.
Who?
You know, Mandalorian, Star Wars.
Yeah. Military?
Yeah, corporal. I was stationed in Delaware at a base called Fort Conoyer. It was pretty cool.
Why weren't you there when this all started?
I was medically discharged. Tweaked my leg really bad. Still bothers me most days.
But, man, I can't imagine the chaos there.
I had a buddy there.
Staff Sergeant Matthew Lawton.
He's my best friend. Quite the sharpshooter, too. I always wonder what happened to him and everyone else.
Well, at least you didn't have to face this shit on the front lines.
You got that right.
Why'd you take the other ones off?
Just didn't seem important anymore.
Well, I used to be, or still am in high school. I worked at a movie theater, though.
You were also the fastest kid in your high school.
Yeah, well, yeah, whatever.
Track?
Yeah. I won the mile race 3 times at state.
And how many times did you qualify and go to state for the mile?
3 times.
No, I was never very good at track.
So, you being from a city, do you know anything about this that we don't?
About the virus?
Yeah.
As much as everyone else, I guess. Bites infect you, but we all carry whatever it is anyway, so whenever we die, our brain's fine. We come back. It's one of those things.
That has to be how it hit so hard. With all the people who die every day anyhow.
So, how do you think we all got it?
Who knows? Could have been airborne, water supply. Doesn't really matter much now, though.
So you don't know what it is either?
I don't think anyone does.
Outside's clear. There might be decays on the inside, though.
What?
Decays. That's what we call the infected. What do you call them?
Never really called them anything. Alright, you guys take the main house. I'll take the surrounding buildings. Let's move in.
gun safe. I'll search you later. Toilet paper. Idiots. Oh man. Score. Son of a...
Norman, you alright?
Yeah. I'm good. I'm good. You want some ramen?
Did she draw on you?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Steven, grab her back. Let's see what she had.
What? No!
Steven, come on, just grab it.
Fine.
Hey, go ahead and hand me that rifle. This gun doesn't even work.
What?
Yeah, it's old. It's not even loaded. She must have used it as a scare tactic.
Damn it.
Nice hat, by the way.
Alright. Carrots. Peaches. Beans. Pears. Okay.
Huh. A journal?
What's this?
And a picture.
Guess I'll read this. Me and Jennifer. $2. So, her name was Lily. Same old, Gunner didn't help out.
What?
She was held up in here for a while, but before that, she was part of a group. A group ran by two brothers, one named Richard and the other Sean.
Sean had a brother?
It seems so.
Jeez. How big of a group?
Well, it says here that she escaped, but not before stealing some supplies. And apparently she saw search parties looking for her.
So bad enough people to spare to look for her. Why'd she escape?
Well, it says here No way.
What?
Apparently, there was rumors about a safe haven in California. A place walled off from the infection, a place that was safe. Called the neighborhood. It seems like she was going towards there.
Where? Where in California?
Let me see. Between Los Angeles and Bakersfield.
Wouldn't California be ground zero for the infection? You know, with its insane population?
Maybe, but... Well, this could be what we've been looking for. A place to settle down and just start making a life.
I know
you want us to stay in the move, stay protected, and just stay alive, but... This could be our chance. This could finally be away from this nightmare.
It's what Mom would want.
Watch it, little brother.
Just think about it. Guys, we have a bigger problem.
Bigby.
Oh, jeez. What kind of freak made this?
Stay here for the night.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Do you want to move the body out and let me get far enough away?
Not gonna stay in the house?
The house is too obvious. At least if we stay out here, we can know if something's coming, and we won't be the immediate target. Besides, there's one body in here, and there's two in the house.
You guys have the fun in there, huh?
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Baby!
Well, well, well. What in the fuck do we have here? Now, let's just drop the weapons and have a goddamn civilized talk. Good. Good. And you. You have something that belongs to my brother. Where is he?
Get off me.
Give me that gun. Yep, this is definitely is. Quite the group we have here. You know, boys, past couple of days have been pretty fucking crazy for me. A member from my group took off, stole supplies. Then my brother goes missing. So then we're out looking for him, too. Then we hear gunshots. Come to find a bunch of biters trying to get in the garage. We lure them away, come back,
and we find the deserter, dead as fuck, and three new faces. Now, normally, I let you guys go, but one of you has my brother's gun. So that's fucking crazy! Oh wait, where are my manners? Where are my manners? I'm Richard O'Ryan. And after today, that's a name you'll remember. Oh, and my boy, Charles here, he's in training. Exactly who the fuck are all of you?
I'm Norman. This is my brother Steven. And this is Bigby.
Bigby, huh? So I'm guessing, since you have my brother's revolver, he's dead. Isn't he?
Yeah.
You're the one that killed him? Talk!
It was me. It was me.
So, you killed my brother?
Yeah. He was threatening us. We were just camping out, trying to make it through the night. So I killed him.
I swear to tell my sister hears about this.
Look, do what you will. Just let the others go.
So, Norman, is it? It's not that simple. This your hammer? Nice. You see, Norman? You killed my brother. It's only fair I kill yours.
Wait, wait, no!
Kill someone!
Woo! What the fuck?
Come on, man. Sit up. Sit up.
Right. Right.
How bad is it? Oh, man.
Here.
KTCL 93.3 Denver, Colorado. I'm gonna be here for as long as I can keep playing music and getting out new information during these crazy times. As a reminder, everyone should avoid any and all contact with the infected individuals. Those numbers keep rising, and before we know it, it will be everywhere. So everyone should stay the hell home. We gotta beat this together, people. This virus, it won't win. We won't let it. Having said that, please enjoy the next song by Tom Petty, Won't Back Down.
Take a break. Big B.
Fine.
Big B?
No, we need to keep going.
Big B, we need to move! Yeah.
You motherfuckers! You think you can just get away? If I don't kill you, my men, my sister will hunt you down!
Pressure.
Just... That's twice.
Thanks.
You know, if I find out that they're actually triplets, I'm gonna fucking shoot myself. Shots. There's gonna be more of them. We gotta go.
No. Just leave. Leave me here.
Norman, I'm not gonna let you die here.
No.
Jess. Just sit with me for a bit. Ugh. Here.
We're saving this for a special occasion.
I guess dying's as good as any. This wasn't on you.
No, not that. Steven. Why did you do that? Take the blame. I mean, he would have killed me and that would have been that. But why?
You saved us. From Sean. It was my turn to save you.
Well, if you would have known what was gonna happen, would you have still done it?
I told our mother I would take care of him. And I failed. But maybe it's not that bad. After all, Steven, he always talked about having a life. Something that wasn't this. This world. He was too good for it. It's no place for a kid.
I'm just happy. He doesn't have to endure any more of this.
I had a kid. His name was Christian. I had a wife. Her name was Lauren. I lost them, beginning of all this. was, it was a lot like this, actually. Warren? High school sweethearts. But I got her pregnant our junior year. And so you can imagine we were forced to grow up fast. Eventually we had our boy. And when he was 5, he got diagnosed with brain cancer. So we just started working and pay for the treatments. And it hit really bad about a month before everything happened. We were in the hospital. But then everything did happen and they kicked us out. So, Lauren and I started taking care of him from home. Trying to get him as much time as possible. We saw the news. We didn't even really care. I mean, we had a dying boy in our hands.
No. Christian! No.
But eventually he lost his battle. And he died.
The news.
What?
The news. The people. No one's coming back to life. Infected.
What's your point?
He's gonna come back as one of those things.
We do not know that.
Yes! Yes, we do! The news said that. That we all have it. That it lies dormant in our brain until we die. He's gonna come back.
Lauren. I can't. Not him.
We have to.
I can't, Lord, I just can't do it.
Grab the knife. I'll do it.
Lord, no, I
Bigby! Think... I'm not letting my son come back as one of those things.
Back.
Shit.
And he bit his mother. And so I had to.
Maybe I can go out and get some antibiotics.
Just sit with me.
My wife, she... she knew what the bites meant. We both did. So... she made me promise... to keep going. To keep fighting. To keep surviving. So that's what I've been doing. And after the world I've seen, I'm grateful they weren't able to. So I know how you feel. Trust me, I do.
Survive for us too.
Of course I will.
Showing me that not everyone in this world is horrible.
You too.
Do this to me. They thought they were made for each other. Won't be thinking of one another. Never thinking just for one second she would take a different attraction. We don't want them. We don't want them. We don't want them. Oh no. We don't want them. We don't want them. We don't want them. Oh no. Can't go on without you. I can't go on without you. Can't go on without you. So what's the point of breaking my sweetheart? She wanted me to let down my guard. Well, you know what they say, it's better that way. So, you better hush and walk away. We don't want them. We don't want them. We don't want them. Keep it all inside, though the thought it crossed my mind to do all the things I regret. We don't want them. We don't want them. We don't want them. We don't want them. Oh no. We don't want them. We don't.
Boss?
Yeah?
We found your brother.
Sean?
No, Richard. Well, sorry.
What happened?
Well, we were able to recover this. And we listened to the tape recorder your brother used to carry around. Sounds like he found out who killed Sean. They also killed him too, Lily Ward included.
The deserter?
Yeah. Everybody was accounted for. Except for one.
Who?
Well, his name's Bigby, and that's all we know about him. I already have scouts out all looking for him. But we did find this on Lily's body. It's a map routed to California, and we think he might be going there. What do you want us to do? Azalea!
Get everyone ready to move. We're headed west.
Okay, I'm on it.
And Wilson? We're going to find whoever did this. And we're gonna make them pay.
Thank you.
the sunset 365 times, with murder running deep in my heart. And if I didn't directly pull the trigger, I sure as hell